church shakeup tonight. Some local churches are closing their doors for good. Good evening to you. I'm Cherie Palello. Mike Dardis has the night off. Lifelong parishioners are going to have to make some big changes now. And WLWT News 5's Brian Hamrick has the impact in tonight's big story.
Well, this is St. John the Baptist Church. It's one of the oldest Catholic churches in all of Indiana with a proud past. But after it showed up on a list of those set to be closed, it's the future of this church and several others that's in question.
They're the kind of churches...
Oh, they're nice. Very nice.
...where people don't measure the time they've been there in years.
They're beautiful. They're beautiful.
But in generations.
My mother was raised in this parish and my dad in Yorkville's parish. I mean, it's just been our family. Our families.
Church members Vera Ahouse and her husband Henry live three doors down from St. Paul in New Alsace, one of the churches set to close.
Well, it makes you feel a little on the sad side.
Many Catholics in Southeast Indiana are concerned after the Archbishop of Indianapolis announced sweeping changes that will affect 27 churches in the Batesville Deanery. A dozen of those are slated to close, including St. Joseph's in St. Leon, where Paul Ollig mows the cemetery.
And all my aunts, uncles, parents, brothers are in the cemetery.
And out here, he can't help but think losing the church will be like losing another family member.
A little upsetting at first, because, you know, you've been here all your life, you got all these buildings here in the cemetery.
St. Martin in Yorkville, St. John the Baptist, established in 1824, along with St. Joseph and St. Paul, will become one church by the end of 2015. But no details on how that happens or what becomes of the church property, leaving the faithful to lean on what they've learned in these buildings as they deal with what happens to them. And it's not just the church itself, but on each of these properties, there's a number of other buildings, and what happens to those? That's in question as well. Brian Hamrick, WLWT News 5.
Okay, so most of the 27 churches affected by these changes will be merging with another church. Now, we know that's a lot of information. To see Brian's story again and get more information on this, go to our website, WLWT.com.